स्टार्ट सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माण विदाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुं हरिमात्मति प्रकाशमुक्षुरुहि शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः श्री चिद्घन गणेश नमो वैभव सुखम नित्यम सुप्रकाशम व्यापक नाम रूप अधिष्ठान बुद्धि बुद्धिम बुद्धेर दुखेतुल अपारम सर्व वेदांत वेद्यम प्रत्येक परम महा तदेव हन मीनस्तामति ही संसार विषय के विचार सो 250 फोर्थ आवर्तन आवर्त आफ्टर संसार विषय विचार देर द क्वेश्चन इज आंसर्ड व्हाट इज संसार हाउ इज क्रिएशन क्रम सो स्वप्नवत विना क्रम जगत प्रतीति दि Prapancha continues to appear just like Swapna without any Krama. The Krama which is discussed. So, Shrutyukta Kramena Jagadutpatti Katane Sutrakara Bhashya Krutoho Avipraayaha. If the Prapancha is created without any Krama, the Krama has no Tatparya, if that is the case, then why would Sutrakara, Brahma Sutrakara, Vyasacharya and Bhagavan Bhashyakara, what is their idea in bringing out the Krama, spending so much time in details also, as this is the Krama, it is not random, why would they say so? So Yadyapi, so Sutra Bhashya, कृतौ वी नो हु सूत्रकार एंड भाष्यकार सो सूत्र शब्देन व्यास कृत ब्रह्म सूत्रम एंड भाष्य शब्देन श्री शंकर भगवत पाद भाष्यं च ग्राह्यम जस्ट इन केस समबडी इज नॉट क्लियर सो टिप्पणकार मेंशन्स दैट यद्यपि सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ द्वितीय अध्याये जगदुत्पत्ति प्रतिपादक श्रुतिवाक्यानां परस्पर विरोधं परिहरन्तु तैतिरियोक्त सृष्टिक्रमः एव सर्वोपनिषद अर्थ इति वर्णितवंतो सो ऑल्दो वी सी दैट सूत्रकार एंड भाष्यकार टॉक्स अबाउट इट इन द्वितीय अध्याय देयर आर लॉट ऑफ डिटेल्स गिवन इन जगत उत्पत्ति विचार दि श्रुतिज टॉकिंग अबाउट इट इवन दी इनफैक्ट दी फर्स्ट सूत्र आफ्टर दी अथातो ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा जन्माद्यस्य यतः सो जन्माद्यस्य यतः हैज बीन सेड यतः ब्रह्मणः जन्मादयः भवन्ति सो दैट ब्रह्म शुड बी इंक्वायर्ड इनटू विच ब्रह्म हु इज द सोर्स ऑफ दिस क्रिएशन फ्रॉम विच ब्रह्म रादर टू बी वेरी लिटरल टू द सूत्र From whichever there is Janma Ityadi, that Brahma should be inquired into. So Shrushti has definitely been mentioned. So Krama is discussed further by Sutrakara and Bhashyakara. There Jagadutpatti Pratipadaka Shruti Vakyanam Paraspara Virodham Pariharantau. The questioner asks in Bhashya, there is a Purva Paksha as to why is it said in one way in this Shruti. The creation Krama is mentioned in one way, and in another Shruti it is mentioned in another way. So paraspara, mutually they are opposed to each other, and the contradiction, mutual contradiction which is apparent in the Shruti should be resolved. This is the role of the Acharya or the commentator there. So there the Krama, if there is a difference in Krama in Chandogya versus Taittiriya, for example, that is resolved in the Bhashya and this Brahma Sutra. Taittiriya Ukta Srishti Krama Eva Sarva Upanishadam Arthaha. Even in Chandogya, whatever has been said as Trivitkaranam, there also Panchikaranam is indicated. We saw the resolution last time as well. Because Agni as the first Bhuta includes Vayu and Akasha. This is the resolution Parihara given by Sutrakara and Bhashyakara. But why is it done if Krama is not the Tatpari of the Shruti? Tad Mandadikari Samadhanartham Iti Jneyam. So here Sadhu says that it is for Mandadikari. They are stuck on the question. If there is Virodha, they do not know how to do Tatpari analysis. And if you tell them, yes, there is opposition, so that is not the Tatpari, and you move on, or you say only this is right, that is right, or whatever. Any other resolution poses a threat that the person may lose Shraddha. One who does not know Tatpari analysis can be picky. Why I'll pick this? This is right. This is not right. So it may lead to Ardhajaratiya Nyaya. Ardhajaratiya Nyaya is dangerous. So this is not Ardhajaratiya Nyaya. You have to know the Tatparya. And Tatparya analysis is not known to the student or the Purva Paksha. Therefore, that audience being Manda Adhikari, because Srishti is needed. The discussion of Srishti itself is for Manda Adhikari. Details there. Mandadikari Samadhanartham Iti Jneyam. Yeah, it looks like a typo. I didn't even look at that. So, Adhikari, Madadikari, there is no Madadikari. So it's a typo. Purvam Varnitam Utpatti Vakyana Vastuhutam Abhiprayam Avagantum Asamarthaha. So, what I said here is Purvam Varnitam Utpatti Vakyana Vastubhutam Abhiprayam. What is the reality in to be understood in this Srishti Krama also, which is discussed across Shrutis? It is not that Shruti cannot resolve the contradictions. Shruti could have done, but Shruti has left a hint there. It's one of the Tatparya Linga. There is no abhyas of Krama, particularly a methodology has not been mentioned across Upanishads. There is no Samyam. And that Samyam isn't there for this very reason. Shruti wants you to do Nishchaya yourself. If everything is spoon-fed, then it is not Jnana. Jnana needs Vichara. Vichara is encouraged by the Shruti by saying, see, I have told you this way, I have told you that way. What is the reality? So it's a puzzle to be solved. It's a mathematical equation to be solved. However you take it, you have to do it yourself in the end. Vichara has to be there. Otherwise, jnana won't be sthira. It won't be complete either, let alone sthira. Therefore, Purvam Varnitam Utpatti Vakyanam Vastubhutam Abhiprayam Avagantum Asamarthaha. They are incapable. Manda Jijnyasavaha. Those who are, they are Jijnyasus. Nyatumichu. But then, still, little slow to catch up. Paraspara Viruddhani Vakyani Drishtva Bhrantama Abhuvanniti. Let them not get deluded, confused. Here it is confused. Why is it so here? Why is it so there? So we have to bring in and put them together, all these, you have to do samanvaya. Basically, samanvaya has to be done. They all talk about a particular krama. And then it is easy. Okay, I understand now. You have to fill in the gaps. So they fill in the gaps, and then the shishya, the purvapakshi, are comfortable. You go further, and then apavada is done. Apavada cannot be done right at the beginning when there is a adhyaropa prakriya going on. Sutra bhashya krutau sarvopanishadam akashadi kramena eva jagadutpattau tatparyam iti pradarshayamasatuhu. They are all rarely seen forms. So, litlakara, nal atus, us. Those pratyas are seen here. Atus, very rare to see a dual. And litlakara here. So, they showed this, the jagadutpattau tatparyam they have shown, both of them, sutrakara and bhashyakara. Sarvopanishadam akashadikramena eva jagadutpattu tatparyam. So they gave them a middle step of the tatparya as to all the shruti kramas indicate this one krama which is completely detailed as it is in Taittiriya Upanishad. Begins with akasha, ends with prithvi. There are five elements. So this is how it is talked about. Kincha Vedanta vicharana yathartha jnanam alabhamanasya laya chintanartham api shrutinam vaimatya pariharena vivakshitaha jagad utpatti kramaha sutra bhashya krutbhyam pradarshitaha. Pradarshitaha, the kramaha, kramaha, jagad utpatti krama is shown, pradarshitaha, by sutra and bhashyakara. Why? Kincha, moreover, what is the reason? Vedanta vicharena. Vedanta is taught, then there is vichara. And then there is dhyana also. Jai chintane. With the jai chintane dhatu, dhyana is also chintana. Even if you take it as meditation, contemplation or meditation also, when dhyana is done, what do you do dhyana on? To land on the dhyana, it is not an object that you take and you do dhyana on that. The dhyana is on a vishaya. Vishaya is not object here. Vishaya can mean subject matter also. In Sanskrit, vishaya is a loaded word. Vishaya saptami, subject matter. Vishaya padartha, there it is an object. So an object of meditation in the yogika prakriya, yogika darshana, yoga darshana, there dhyana needs a vishaya as an object. That object can be anything. There, that sutrakara, Patanjali Maharshi says, you can do dhyana, he gives us set of samplings. He just says, you can do dhyana on shabda, rupa, any of these. You can do dhyana on prana. You can do dhyana on Ishvara, any murti. So, amurta, murta, amurta, all this is possible. And then in the end, he says that these are just examples. You can do dhyana on whatever you like. Dhyana is possible on anything and everything. Now, here the matter is so delicate that dhyana, chintana has to be done on your own self, who is a meditator. The very content of the meditator is to be meditated upon, which is impossible because you cannot objectify the objectifier. So, chintana has to be done in a manner where you go from the gross to the subtle. Thereby, you have to start from the grossest creation, and therefore, creation has to be talked about. Krama is also needed because it will aid the final stage of resolution also. Initial stage also, beginning with dhyana, which is a yogika process, ending with dhyana, which may or may not be a yogika process. So, yathartha jnanam alabhamanasya, who has not understood the tatparya, who cannot use neti neti in totality initially. Just when it is said that when the shruti pulls the carpet under the legs of the sadhaka, he is standing on that. Vedi Adhikarana is taken away by saying that Prapancha Mithya. He is a part of that very Prapancha. He does not consider himself as Brahma. He does not understand how is that possible. So he says, oh, all this is Mithya. And then there is a shock. That wouldn't work. This shock treatment does not work. You know, it has this risk of the person becoming further deluded. So here, Krama is discussed for that reason also. And Bhashyakara and Sutrakara, they encourage this Krama so that the Shishya is benefited as to slowly one can resolve the gross into a lesser gross or a more subtle. And so on till this subtlest of all, the very self is reached. Resolution ground is finally Brahmatma. Therefore, Laya Chintanartham Api. For the Laya Chintana also, Shruti Nam Vaimatya Pariharena Vivakshitaha Jagat Utpatti Kramaha. That is also another reason. Sutra Vashyakritbhyam Pradarshitaha, they have presented it in that manner. It should not be taken idamittham as that is the reality, that is the final reality. Tatparya isn't that. That is just a tool. It's an aid to land the Shishya. More handholding is done there. Yena kramena utpattihi tadviparita kramena jagataha laya chintaniya. So how is this laya chintana facilitated by this pradarshana of shruti krama? Because however the krama of srishti is, resolution is in the reverse manner. In fact, in Ayurveda text, it is said, I was asking an Ayurvedic doctor once, Ayurvedic Vaidya. Doctor has a different connotation, so we'll say Vaidya. The butter can be made into ghee, ghrata. So Navanita is converted to ghrata. Somewhere it was mentioned, you know, the reverse process. He said, yes, they had experimentation. You have to reverse the ghrata into Navanita. You change the ghee back into butter. How is it possible? We don't know such things easily. We don't know them easily. There may be possibilities. So ghee is produced by heat. You apply heat to butter, you get ghee. So that ghee, ghrata, is washed with cold. Washed in the sense processed through cold. Then it turns back to butter. Reverse engineering. In modern language, reverse engineering. In Vyakrana, we do that. We reverse engineer the pada and land into the dhatu. However, the dhatu has been derived, you reverse engineer. Take away the pratyaya, you take away the upasarga, you take away the gunavriddhi ityadi, sandhi, gunavriddhi ityadi, you land on dhatu. The code is reverse engineer in software language, those who belong to software, so they understand this reverse engineering. Here, Laya Chintana is also like that. However, it has been created, you reverse engineer it in the mind cognitively, because Jnana is in the Antakkarana, it has to take place in the Buddhi. In understanding, it is reversed, and the Krama helps there. Oh, okay, this is how you have to go back. Same process is used in Chandogya also. And in multiple ways, they do color coding also. Very technical, you know. In modern world, you do color coding. There are short forms used. Short forms are there in Vyakrana. In MBA, you know, they teach you how to remember easily by making short forms, and then you remember in that manner. They are called as Pratyahara. In Vyakrana, you have Pratyahara. Came from the Shiva's Damru. Ayon, Rilak, Ayon, Ityadi. Helps you remember. Now, the Srishti Krama is also like that. You have to reverse engineer. And Chandogya uses color coding. Agni is red. Then Jala is white. Then you land on Prithvi. It's of a dark color. Some dark color. And then what is said is, wherever you see this, wherever you see these colors, they are all manifestations of those very basic elements. So you can reverse engineer in that manner. What about something which is neither, I mean, which does not have red, white, or these dark brown or black color, whatever, a dark shade. So there it is said, these variegated colors also are mixtures of these three in various proportions. So we understand in painting or in photography also, you have three primary colors. Either you have RGB in photography or in painting, you have in the negative colors. So you have red, blue, and yellow. And every color is a mixture of these. Every other color. Similarly, Chandogya says in the Prapancha, wherever you see anything, if you see these colors, even if you don't see these colors, do you see some color? Rupa. Rupa is color. You see some rupa. That rupa is nothing but these three colors manifesting, these three elements manifesting. So you can land on these, and then each of these, you can go back into their subtle forms. And the subtle forms have a krama. The gross do not have krama. Gross have mixture of the subtle elements which have a krama. So once you have landed on that basic set of three gross elements in Chandogya or in Taittiriya, five elements, then you reverse engineer. If you reverse the krama, you resolve the prithvi into jala, jala into vayu, and in Chandogya, once that is done, it can be bridged to Taittiriya also. Then you resolve the srishti krama opposite to that. You reverse and resolve the akash into akasha. Finally, you have to resolve. So you resolve the agni into vayu and vayu into akasha. This akasha is resolved into Brahman. Mandukya also uses it. Mandukya does not talk about srishti, but still it resolves at various levels. Resolutions are talked about. So there, akara, ukara, makara. Omkara is made of akara, ukara, makara. So resolution is done of akara, which is representative of the entire gross prapancha. Stula prapancha. Stula prapancha includes the individual and the total. At the individual level, Vishwa, who is the Jagrat Avastha Abhimani. At the universal level, Samashti level. So Vyashti level, Vishwa. Samashti level, we have Virat, Virat Purusha. Along with everything else, the Jagrat Prapancha. Because Jagrat Prapancha Abhimani. All of this is resolved into Akara, which is a representative of the Stula. Basically, Akara and Vishwa are equated. So everything is resolved into Vishwa. This Vekar Vishwa has Virat also within. It's not the other way around. Elsewhere, resolution is done from individual into Vyashti into Samashti. All Vyashtis are resolved into Samashti. In Mandukya, there are not many Vyashtis. There is only one Vyashti. There is only one individual Jiva. And there is one Ishvara. There is one Virat. So at each level, there is one at the total level and at the individual level. So who is this Jiva? Jiva is either Vishwa, appears as Vishwa. He appears as Taijasa in Swapna. Swapna Avastha Abhimani. Swapna Sukshma Sharira Abhimani. At the Samashti level, there is Hiranyagarbha. And there is Swapna Prapancha. So Jagrat Prapancha, inclusive of the Virat Purusha and Vishwa, are resolved into the Taijasa. Taijasa includes this Samashti. Hiranyagarbha is also resolved into this Taijasa, and along with him, he is resolved into the Shushupti. During the Shushupti Avastha, resolved into Prajna at the Vyashti level, and Samashti level, there is Ishvara, called as Antaryami there. Who is Ishvara? We should not think that, oh, Ishvara is resolved into Jiva. Yes, it's a Prakriya. Don't agree with the Prakriya, it's okay, you use something else. But Mandukya, you have to understand the Prakriya. So Samashti is resolved into Vyashti. Here, you resolve the samashti gradually here in the Taittiriya or in the Chandogya Upanishad. There it is, the resolution is pretty simple. Whichever works to for whichever sadhaka, and then that prajna is also finally resolved into turiya. So turiya atma, brahma atma, nirguna brahma is the final ground of all resolutions, because other than that turiya brahma atma, there is nothing. Nothing has its reality. Everything is borrowed. Like the colors are borrowed, the padartha is borrowed, indicated or known through the color combination in the Chandogya Prakriya. Chandogya does not have only this Prakriya. There is one of that mentioned. Basically, the Karana, Sarvakaranam Karanam, Sarvakaryanam Karanam. So you land from the Karya to the Karana and keep on going till you land on Karana Rahita, Sarvakarana Karanam. That happens to be Brahmatma finally. Thereby, yena kramena utpatti tadviparita kramena jagataha layaha chintaniya. This srishti krama helps. However, it is mentioned, tatpare is not in srishti krama. If you understand any srishti krama, if you can reverse it and resolve it, then you have landed on one who is the real entity to be inquired into, who is the tatpare of the shruti, of all shrutis. So adhyaropa prakriya is aided by apavada prakriya is aided by this adhyaropa. How adhyaropa krama helps the apavada krama? That is the reason that the details are discussed, not to explain the world. The shruti has no reason to explain the world beyond what you already know. What you already know, it goes back. It does not take you further as to how these processes work, why it happens, none of that. Ekena jnanena sarvam jnatam bhavati. That eka has to be known. Tatha laya chintanena advitiya brahmani buddhihi stira bhavet. Then in advitiya brahma, the buddhi becomes stira. There is no issue. There are no questions to be dealt with later. If you know the srishti krama, you can go back. So yam laya chintana prakaraha vartika karaihi sureshwara acharyaihi panchikaranakhya granthe varnitaha. And in Prakarana Granthas also, Bhagavan Vartikakara, Bhagavan Sureshwaracharya deals with the Laya Chintana Prakara, how this has to be inquired into, how this resolution has to be done by Sadhaka in the Grantha called as Panchikarana. Panchikarana is the process, but Panchikarana is also the name of the, Panchikarana means grossification in the Taittiriya Upanishad, grossification of the five subtle elements. But Panchikarana Grantha talks about this Laya Chintana. Asya Granthasya Uttamadikari Vishayatvad. Yadyadapi, this should be Yadyapi. Yadyapi Jagadutpatti Layakrama Varnanasya Natra Avasaraha Tathapi. So Asya Granthasya Uttamadikari Vishayatvad. This Grantha caters to Uttamadikari. Who is the Uttamadikari? We can simplify it. See, Uttamadikari. Caters to Uttamadhikari means Uttamadhikari, one who is a mumukshu really. That is the Uttamadhikari. Moksha ichchu. Thereby Jijnyasu. Jijnyasu, see, it is said that mumukshatvam should become Jijnyasa. Should lead to Jijnyasa. That is only in Vedanta we talk about it in that manner. Jijnyasa is Jnatum Iccha. Kimartham Jnatum Iccha is questionable. A jijnyasu who is not a mumukshu is not the goal at all. That jijnyasa is not even encouraged. It is discouraged. Discouraged in the sense that jijnyasa is needed. Whereby one can have viveka driven vairagya. So a jijnyasa into the prapancha makes a person a vairagi, which precedes this mumukshutvam. Mumukshutvam followed by jijnyasa is something else. There mumukshutvam is needed. Jijnyasa is a byproduct of it. Brahma jijnyasa. That jijnyasa atato brahma jijnyasa. That is a follow on. What is the earlier jijnyasa? That jijnyasa is dharma jijnyasa. अथातो धर्म जिज्ञासा अथातो अधर्म जिज्ञासा अपि दैट इज दैट विल लीड टू वैराग्य. सो विवेक ड्रिवन वैराग्य देन षट संपत्ति देन समाधि षटक संपत्ति देन मुमुक्षुत्व. दिस मुमुक्षुत्व लीड्स टू ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा. सो देयर आर टू जिज्ञासा. वी आर इंटरेस्टेड इन ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा नॉट इन दैट जिज्ञासा विच लीड्स टू वैराग्य. ऑल्दो दैट हैज टू बी देयर. Without that, it is not possible. Therefore, mumukshutvam is there. And what is mumukshutvam? It is not moksho me bhut. Moksho me bhut abhut. Moksho me bhut, there is yeng of padanta jati, sandhi has taken place. Abhut. May there be moksha for me. When you have that sankalpa, then there cannot be another sankalpa. There can be no sankalpa. So if you say that, what does it mean? In simple language, it means let me be free. You cannot be binding yourself and expect to be free. That is lack of viveka itself. Mumukshuttam bahuduram. It is lack of viveka. Doing, so it is like wanting to climb up something and you dig a hole. It's an abyss. You'll never come out of it. Cannot have opposite pursuits. Therefore, karma and sadhana. Sadhana in a sense, the karma and moksha do not go together. That's why dvenishte, maya prokte. Dvenishte, maya prokte. Why Gita Acharya Bhagavan Krishna says two nishtas? Either you have pravritti or you have nivritti. You cannot have pravritti and nivritti both together. Cognitively at least. So there cannot be two commitments. Two different commitments can be there. They will finally merge into one by dropping one. It is not along with the baggage. So if you want to go up the, it's like climbing the Himalayas, you know. Those who have done some trekking, they know that the more you go higher, even your handkerchief and socks become heavier. So you have to drop off. Initially you drop off, you carry limited baggage. So travel light. Anywhere you travel light, then in trekking, you travel lighter. If you want to go to the peak, go higher up, then you have to start dropping the final hold-ons also. So it's that there also there is a krama. Some people can just drop off like Mandukya. Drop off everything in a simple process. So all this is mithya, though they can drop off everything and walk out from the society, they become sannyasis, ashrama sannyasis, bala sannyasis. Others need time, but does not mean that they can hold on to it and get it. Therefore, where uttamadhikarityam is mentioned, we should take it that finally I have to reach there. Mumukshutvam, where moksha eva me bhut, that is the real mumukshuttvam, tivra mumukshuttvam. So thereby yadyapi jagadutpatti laya krama varnanasya natra avasara. So why jagadutpatti, why discussion on jagadutpatti if it is catering to uttamadhikari? Tathapi, even then, why this grantha, Vichara Sagara talks about, name is Vichara Sagara. Sagara cannot say that I will not include this river. Whichever river merges in, that has to be taken care of. So whatever type of the adhikarityam, if the adhikarityam is there, then it caters to that also. Thereby, Sagara Rupatvad Asya Granthasya Manda Anugrahaya Sangshepataha Sa Uchyate. Therefore, Manda Adhikari also is catered to briefly though. So that there is some trigger of Vairagya. That is why initially also Bharchukatha has particular application in the context of the Uttama Adhikari. But for the, in the Uttama Adhikari also there are gradations. But in the Bharchukatha, the details that we have gone through, that is for what purpose? Is because it is for Manda Anugraha. Asangatvad akriyatvacha shuddha brahmana sakasha jagadutpatyadikam na sangachate. So, you know, Mandadikari will understand that Asanga Brahma has been talked about. How can Asanga Brahma be a Karana for Jagat? Akriyatvacha has no Kriya. And then suddenly he says he creates the Prapancha. How can it be? It is contradictory. So, some turbulence is created in the mind so that the Shishya starts asking questions. Pariprashnena sevaya. This Pariprashna, Paritha Prashna, inquiring into each and every aspect, that lands you on the goal. This is what the Mandadikari will also start doing. Thereby, Shuddha Brahmana Sakasha. Shuddha Brahma is Nirguna Brahma. There is no Ashuddha Brahma. So we should not take it in that manner. Shuddha Brahma is this. Shuddha Brahma is Maya Ashabalita Brahma. One who is not affected by Maya. Affected in the sense associated. Not affected at all. Associated. There is no Sambandha with Maya. Anyway, there is no Sambandha. But even in the perspective of the Jiva inquiring into Ishvara, Ishvara is with Maya Shakti. So Maya Shakti Sambandha is there. Where it is not there, that kind of a Brahma is called as Shuddha Brahma. So we should not use a Shuddha Brahma just because Shuddha Brahma has been used. Some people have an issue. Oh, does that mean Saguna Brahma Ishvara is Ashuddha? Is my Ishta Devata? What kind of Vedanta is this? So they consider it as blasphemy and walk out. So it has to be explained. They have to be understood. These words which are used, Shuddha Brahma means that which has no association with Maya Shakti also. For you, that kind of a Ishvara is powerful. That kind of an Ishvara. But in Vedanta, that association has made him a Karta, Srishti Karta, without the Kartrutvam, but still a Srishti Karta. Then Shruti is saying that he is Asanga and Akriya. Asanga we can still understand, but Akriya, Srishti Karta and Akriya, how can that be? Therefore, you have to land on that Shuddha Brahma bereft of. Why Shuddha? This Ashuddha aspects that we have, because the Srishti is not Shuddha. So that Ashuddhi is superimposed on the Srishti Karta, because how has it come otherwise? There are some gunas. There are some, not only sattva, there is rajas and tamas guna also. This has to be there in the karana, otherwise how it has come in the prapancha, which is the karya. There we have to think of maya. Thereby, not Shuddha. Some association. There is no balina sattva. Sattva is there, but sattva itself becomes a taint, so to say. Punya for a sadhaka becomes an issue. Forces that sadhaka to take janma. So punya should not be dropped initially, but later punya in sankalpa should be dropped as well. Initially punya is needed to take away papa, counter papa. Then punya also has to be dropped. Similarly, rajasa is needed to bring out one from tamasa. Then rajasa has to be controlled by sattva. Finally, sattva also has to be dropped. That is Shuddha Brahma. From that, Brahma, utpatyadikam na sangachyati. You cannot have utpatti, no? And utpatti, sthiti and laya. You cannot have that. Kintu maya vishishta shabala brahmanaha sakashad jagad utpadyate. Tasmad mayeshwarayo swarupam pratipadyate. So, the creation is possible only from Maya Vishishta Shavala Brahma. That Brahma which has become variegated now, takes various roles, wears different hats, becomes Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara by association, due to association with Maya. And what is this? This is explained here. There are two words there. Granthasya Uttama Adhikari. And here Maya Vishishta. Who is an Uttama Adhikari? That is the first point there. And then Maya Vishishta Shavala Brahma. Drishti Shrishti Vadaika Satta Vadaika Jiva Vadeshu. So Drishti Shrishti Vada Eka Satta Vada Eka Jiva Vadeshu. Drishti Shrishti Vada we have seen a bit. Eka Satta Vada also. Eka Satta, there is only one Satta. There is no other Satta. Eka Jiva Vada. There is Eka Jiva, there is no other Jiva. drishti precedes srishti or srishti is along with drishti, that is drishti srishti vada. So focus is from eka jiva. Mandukya focus is here. Everything is explained from the perspective of one who needs moksha. Ishvara does not need moksha. Prapancha does not need moksha. Who needs moksha? Jiva. So in the triad of jiva, prapancha and Ishvara, jiva needs moksha. Where should the focus be? Not on Ishvara and prapancha. They are all on the sidelines in the context. Prasangat. Prasangat, we have to look into Ishvara and prapancha. If you spend your entire life in Ishvara and in prapancha, how did Srishti come about? Who is the Srishti Karta? Is it Narayan or Shiva? The life is gone. Jiva is one who needs moksha. You are not giving moksha to Ishvara. You are not giving moksha to prapancha. They don't want it. Even if you give it, they don't want it. So who wants it? I, the sadhaka, want moksha. So I, the sadhaka, should be inquired into. Everything should be explained from this jiva's perspective. And that is how the Shruti approaches. The samsara is explained from the jiva's perspective. Therefore, the resolution of Mandukya is not into the Samashti, it is into Vyashti. Both work in the same manner. But the faster Krama is, I don't need to think of other Jivas, I don't need to think of anything else if I can resolve everything into me. I, the Sadhaka, who happens to be Brahma, Brahmatma. So that is Drishti Srishti Vada Prakriya. Fine. Finally, there is no Srishti Ajatavada, but Ajatavada is not like Drishti Srishti Vada, Srishti Drishti Vada. It is like Satkaryavada Ityadi, Asatkaryavada, Satkaryavada. So, it can be seen at that way. Ajatavada, to talk about Satkarya and Asatkarya in Vada, Ajatavada said that none of this is needed because only if there is a Karya, we can inquire into whether the Karana is Sat or Asat. When the Karya itself is not there, Karya is not there means Karya has never been born. Prapancha is not born at all. That is the Prakriya of Mandukya where Ajatavada, Bhagavan Karikakara talks of Ajatavada. Then the inquiry into Satkaryavada is wrong, Asatkaryavada is wrong. But then we hold on to Satkaryavada. Then he says Satkaryavada is also wrong because there is no Karya at all. Anyway, so Drishti Srishti Vadeika Satta Vadeika Jiva Vadeshu Dhridatara Samskara One Uttama Adhikari. So one who has Dhridatara Samskara One. Finally, one who lands in Drishti Srishti Vada, Eka Satta Vada, Eka Jiva Vada, he is the Uttama Adhikari who has those Samskaras. And it will come about over a period of time. Even without being an Uttama Adhikari of this type, one can still use any prakriya and land on aikya and thereby get moksha. So, uttama adhikarittvam is not needed for moksha. Adhikarittvam is needed. Are you a mumukshu who does not want anything finally? Are you a dhridatara mumukshu there? That is where you have to land on. Not on dhridatara uttama adhikarittvam. Uttama adhikarittvam may need many janmas also. We don't know. We cannot say that, oh, I need to understand drishti srishti vada only. No, not needed. If you can land on the Aikya through Tattva Bodha also, Vedanta Sara. Not everyone needs to go to Brihat Prastharatraya, all Upanishads. Upanishads are summarized into Prakrana Granthas and other works in Smritis, Puranas, Itihasas, all the same message is being taught across the board. Anyone and everyone is Adhikari for Moksha if that person has sadhana chatushte sampatti. Sadhana chatushte sampatti being in full measure does not make a person an uttama adhikari. Uttama adhikari needs samskara. This samskara of these samskaras have come across janmas. In one janma, I may or may not get the samskara which will help me understand drishti srishti vada. May or may not. There is a possibility there is. But that should not hold me back from moksha. If I say that, let me work towards understanding these, hard to chew on, those kind of works. I need so much of Tarka Shastra. I need so much of refinement in buddhi. If the refinement in buddhi is sufficient to have viveka on the spot when the antakarana is causing chaos, that is sufficient for an adhikari to hold back, have shamadama, increase that and land on mumukshutvam and hold on to that mumuksha. That is sufficient. Thereby, who is an uttama adhikari here in this context? Drishti srishtivada. One who prefers drishti srishtivada has those samskaras. Those samskaras cannot come in one janma, may not come in one janma. If they are there, they may surface when one does more and more sadhana. Then what is this maya sahita brahma, maya sahita this brahma? That is explained here as in the second point. Jagat vivartopadanam bhutam adhisthanam mayopaita chaitanyam eva. We say Brahma is vivarta upadana karana, maya is parinami upadana karana, but it is said that abhinna nimitta upadana karana is who? Amidna nimitta upadana karana is Brahma. Abhinna, there are no separate. Nimitta and upadana karanas. That is Brahma. That Brahma is along with Maya. Therefore, Maya upaita chaitanyam meva adhisthanam. Whether it is vivarta, upadana. If you talk of parinami, then it is Maya. In upadana karana inquiry also, vivarta upadana is Maya upaita chaitanyam. When you say abhinna nimitta upadana karanam, nimitta is Brahma. There you don't have an issue. Vivarta, all right, I understand. But upadana is also Brahma. How is that? Maya upaita chaitanyam. Natu maya vishishtam. There, maya is an upadhi do. Not a visheshana. Tathapi, he'll explain that. Tathapi maya vishishtasya upadhanatvam tataha jagadutpatti cha aviveka drishtya uchyate. This maya is what? Karyanumeya. It has to be inferred. There is no maya really. Because there is no karya. Karya has no reality. As long as we see karya has some reality, that reality comes by some karana. So karana cannot be nirguna brahma. Therefore maya has to be brought in. This is what Shruti does. It is not something that we have done. We may use some prakriyas where we may explain some things, but Shruti herself brings in. Shruti has done this inference. Anumana need not be done by others only. It is done by Shruti herself. Karyanumeya maya. Some shakti has to be explained and therefore it is inferred as being there. But why is that done? It is done. This visheshana, maya as a visheshana of Brahma is talked about in the Jagadutpatti Prakarana. Aviveka drishtya. Only catering to avivekis. Viveka drishtya tu jagatav parinam yupadhanam va vivarta upadhanam va no maya visishta chaitanya. Maya is not a visheshana whether you talk about this parinami upadhana or vivarta upadhanam. If you are inquiring into it, then maya visishta chaitanya is not the karana there. Kintu jagataha parinam yupadhanam kevala maya. Maya is the only parinami upadhanam. Who is inferred? Basically, karya is a parinama of karana. That karya itself isn't there. Therefore, aviveka drishtya, karya being there, aviveka drishtya, maya has to be talked about. That maya itself isn't there really. Vivarta upadhanam maya upaita chaitanyam. And vivarta upadana is maya upahita chaitanya. Not maya vishishta chaitanya. It is maya. Maya is an upadhi there because maya has no presence real presence. Avivekinahatu ubhaya vidam upadhanatvam maya vishishta chaitanya bhrantya pratiyate. That maya is a visheshana, real shakti of Brahma. All this is an appearance to one who cannot inquire further. For them it is okay, Shruti talks about it, but then If you go into details, when Viveka rises, then you know that it is not true. Maya is the Parinami Upadana Karana, whereas Vivarta Upadana Karana is Maya Upahita Chaitanya. Upadi, not affected at all. That is the Sambandha Rahitattvam. Tasmat Shastrakaraihi Avivekinam Drishtihi Anudyate Kevalam Natu Tatparyena Uchyate Iti Jnayam. So Tatparya isn't there. We have to drop that. Just give me one moment, please. Yeah, anyway, we are at the... So, let's stop here. Where are we? Yeah, we are here. So, I'll just finish this para here. Asya granthasya uttamadikari vishayatvad ityadi udanya maya. Kintu maya vishishta shabala brahmana sakashad jagat utpadyate tasmad mayeshwarayo swarupam pratipadyate. Therefore, the mayeshwara swarupa in prasanga maya and ishwara also are to be inquired into. Therefore, shrutyukta utpatti krama nirupanam and prasangat in the context, what is the karana of this prapancha brahma? Oh, no, wait, what kind of Brahma? Saguna Brahma, oh, what is Sagunatvam kim tatra? What kind of Karana? Upadana Karanam va? Nimitta Karanam va? Then, if one, then what is the Maya there? If not one, then you have to split it. If it is one, then it is Maya and Upadhi or a Visheshana. All these Prasangat Uchyate. Prasangat Maya Swarupa Pratipadanam. So that is the next topic. We look at it in the next part. Sukarnityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Namri Vadishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhe Drakyatvi Nirmala Param Sarvyedantam Sadeva Annamattam Nishchitamati Namaste.